ہر وقت تصور میں مدینے کی گلی ہے، ہر وقت تصور میں مدینے کی گلی ہے، اب در بدری ہے نہ غریب الوطنی ہے، اس شہر میں بھک جاتے ہیں خدا کے خریدار، یہ مصر کا بازار نہیں شہر مدینہ ہے، یہ مصر کا بازار نہیں شہر نبی ہے صلی اللہ علیہ یا رسول اللہ. وسلم علیک یا حبیب اللہ. تیری جالیوں کے نیچے تیری رحمتوں کے سائے، تیری جالیوں کے نیچے تیری رحمتوں کے سائے، تیری جالیوں کے نیچے تیری رحمتوں کے سائے، جسے دیکھنی ہو جنت وہ مدینہ دیکھ آئے، جسے دیکھنی ہو جنت وہ مدینہ دیکھ آئے. روزے کے سامنے میں یہ دعا مانگتا تھا، روزے کے سامنے یہ دعائیں مانگتا تھا، میری جان نکل تو جائے یہ سما بدل نہ جائے، میری جان نکل تو جائے یہ سما بدل نہ جائے، لو چلا ہوں میں لحد میں میرے مصطفیٰ سے کہہ دو، لو چلا ہوں میں لحد میں کہ ہوا تیری گلی کی مجھے چھوڑنے کو آئے، کہ ہوا تیری گلی کی مجھے چھوڑنے کو آئے، تیری جالیوں کے نیچے تیری رحمتوں کے سائے، جسے دیکھنی ہو جنت وہ مدینہ دیکھ آئے.
اللہم صلی وسلم وبارک علیہ.
الحمدللہ رب العالمین الرحمن الرحیم والصلاة والسلام على اشرف الانبیاء والمرسلین وعلى آله وصحبه اجمعین أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ويل للمطففين الذين إذا اكتالوا على الناس يستوفون وَإِذَا كَالُوهُمْ أَوْ وَزَنُوهُمْ يُخْسِرُونَ أَلَا يَظُنُّ أُولَئِكَ أَنَّهُمْ مَبْعُوثُونَ لِيَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ يَوْمَ يَقُومُ النَّاسُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ كَلَّا كتاب الفجار لفي سجين وما أدراك ما سجين كتاب مرقوم ويل يومئذ للمكذبين الذين يكذبون بيوم الدين وما يكذب به إلا كل معتد أثيم إذا تتلى عليه آياتنا قال أساطير الأولين كلا بل ران على قلوبهم ما كانوا يكسبون كلا إنهم عن ربهم يومئذ لمحجوبون آمنت بالله صدق الله العظيم اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا وشفيعنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين السلام علينا وعلى عباد الله الصالحين
ما شاء الله by the فضل فلا سبحانه وتعالى I believe that you can see the screen thus the topic because I will be using certain slides just to explain things more quickly and more effectively. So I request you sit somewhere where you can see and read what's on the screen clearly so that you can follow the message fully. The message is very simple, that if a person wants to be a person who is most loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, most loved by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and even loved by the other creation of Allah, like angels, even the trees, even the other creation, and human beings as well, generally. So that is what people are trying to achieve, and it is a great accomplishment that if Allah loves you, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam loves you, and the other creation also loves you. Because the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said that there is nothing in the heaven and the earth, living or non-living, that does not know that I am the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Similarly, all these creation, they know the enemies and the friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We might not know of how they know, but they understand. The water is just water, but it has a consciousness of its own. It knew when the friends of Allah were passing behind Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam that these are the friends of Allah and I should not harm them, I should not drown them. The water knew. It kept itself away. From whom? The friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the water also knew that when the enemies of Allah are coming, the army, the disobedient people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the army of Pharaoh and his followers, the water knew these are the enemies of Allah and I should destroy them. And as you know, it destroyed. The fire recognizes a friend of Allah who this month is attributed to. Sayyidina Ibrahim al-Khalil. So, alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent us such a gift in the form of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, that he unveiled the secret and the methodology that if you follow his manhaj and his way, Allah will love you, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam will love you, and the creation, the khalq, will also love you. So I just want to go through with you briefly that how is it that you can do, what can you do that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love you? The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam will love you. The creation will love you. But you have to understand certain background. So if you follow me through the screen, inshallah you will understand. Look, when there was no creation, when there was no makhluk, who was there? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It was Allah azza wa jal. Nothing else was there. What else was there? This is something for you to think. Beside the essence, the zaat of Allah, what else was there? the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as you can see round actually on this screen, that there was Allah azza wa jal subhanahu wa ta'ala, and there were his attributes, his sifat, that he is Razzaq, he is Al-Hayy, Al-Qawwi, Al-Mateen, Al-Aziz. You also heard in the tilawat of Quran, the last three verses of Surah Al-Hashr, Huwallahu allazi la ilaha illa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned his sifat. So there was Allah and there was the sifat of Allah. Try to focus on the screen more than me, because you can't read anything on my face. You can hear me through the speaker, but you will be able to see something which will give you more understanding. Because the message is important, I am not important. You are important, and your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is important. So there was Allah and his sifat. So what happened, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as it says in the next, he loved his attributes, he loved his zat, and he loved his sifat. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved his sifat of giving rizq, his sifa of qudra, his sifa of being knowledgeable, alim. All the infinite, we do not know how many qualities there are. They are infinite, they have no limit. So Allah loved his being and his attributes. Due to the divine love for himself and his attributes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will to be known. Because he had love for himself, his sifat, his qualities, so he wanted these qualities to be known. So first thing which he created for that purpose, you're still looking at me, look at the screen. Firstly, to fulfill that purpose, so that he is known, he created the noor of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, the Muhammadan light, and haqiqa Muhammadiyya, the Muhammadan reality. So he created the essence, the noor of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. So here Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam was created as the first creation. Why he was created? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala willed his sifat to be known. So the Muhammadan attributes were created, which reflected the divine attributes. So now Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sifat was also created. Allah's sifat are not created. Allah's zat is not created. He is azaliyun, abadiyun. But Rasulullah SAW had a beginning. His qualities, as you can see, he was Ra'uf, Rahim, Mashhud, Wali, Aziz, Shukur. He has also hundreds and hundreds and thousands and thousands, hundreds and thousands of qualities. All the qualities of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they reflect the quality, the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The rahmah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is reflection of the rahmah of Allah. Every attribute, which can I mention, every attribute of his is the reflection of attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So now you know you know two things. Number one, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's qualities, He loved His qualities and He liked to be known, and for that He created Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and His qualities. So His qualities reflect the qualities of the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As I mentioned to you, in the Quran it's mentioned the two names of Allah, Ar-Ra'uf and Ar-Rahim. And Allah gave it as a gift to Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam as well, these two names, Ra'uf Ar-Rahim. Azizun alayhi ma'anittum harisun alaykum bil mu'mineen Ra'uf Ar-Rahim. But these are created qualities. They are makhluq. The qualities of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is makhluq and his zaat is makhluq. So there is difference. So now, because the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reflected the divine qualities, so Allah loved the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam the most. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could see the reflection of his sifat in the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he could see rahmah, he could see ra'af, he could see the other, all other qualities of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's nur and his zaat reflected the divine qualities. Okay? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also gave an example in the Quran about the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. You must have heard many ahadith like this. For example, look here it says, wherever those qualities will be present, Allah will love that quality. So for example, Allah is gentle, He loves gentleness. Have you not heard this? You must have. Inna Allaha rafiq wa yuhibbu rifq. Allah is gentle. Wa yuhibbu rifq. And Allah loves gentleness. So if gentleness will come in you, Allah will love you as well. So how can you become the beloved of the Creator that you reflect? You also attain the reflection of the divine qualities. If Allah is gentle, you become gentle. And Allah will love you. Inna Allah jameel wa yuhibbul jamal. Allah is beautiful and He loves beauty. He loves beauty in everything. Allah, inna Allah kareem wa yuhibbul karam. Allah is generous. He loves generosity. Allah sakhi hai, usko sakhawat se mohabbat hai. Allah pak rahmat wala hai, usko rahmat se mohabbat hai. So wherever these qualities will be found, Allah will love them. So the way to become the beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you want to become the beloved of the Creator, you should start reflecting the divine qualities which the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam had a reflection. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ. That if you just possess what the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam have, what qualities he has, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Yuhbibukumullah, I will love you. Why will He love you? Because you have got those good traits, good qualities as well. Allah is forgiving. Inna Allah afu. He loves to forgive. Inna Allah afuun kareem. Allahumma innaka afu, tuhibbul afu. Allah is forgiving and He loves forgiveness. So He loves forgiveness. So if you want Allah to love you, become a forgiving person. Become a gentle person. Become, as I said, Allah is merciful, He loves mercy. So you have understood the well, just skip that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran has mentioned the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as Sirajan Munira. Siraj means a lamp, a light. Munir means that it can also make others a light as well. Spreading light, meaning Siraj is like a candle. The candle is lit itself, it can alight other candle as well. It can spread light, it can make, for example, the sun. The sun is Siraj, the sun is a lamp, but it is also Munir. Look, it enlightens the moon. The moon is enlightened by what? The sun. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as though also is the sun of the spiritual world. Hazur alayhi salatu wa sallam ruhani dunya ke suraj hai. Jis tarah is suraj se sari roshni phail rahi hai. Is tarah puri ruhaniyat ki dunya mein, zameen asman mein, farishton mein, wo noor Hazur alayhi salam ki zaat se aa raha. So now you can see this example. Ye misal dekhe. Ye darmiyan mein Huzur alayhi salatu wasalam ki zaat ki misal. The example of the light of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is the center. And all these planets, as you can see, you see that part which is in front of the sun is light. Ab dekhe na jo hissa suraj ke samne hai, wo roshan hai. Jo suraj ke samne nahi, wo andhere mein hai. For example, why is there dark outside now in London? But London mein andhera kyun hai? Why is it dark outside? Simple reason, the sun is there, but the earth has the side of the earth which is facing the sun is still light, but this side of the earth where London is, where UK is, it's not facing the sun, it's turned away from the sun. Because it's turned away from the sun, that's why there is night. When it will come in front of the sun, it will become a light. It will become day in UK. So similarly, think, look at these planets. The half part which is facing the sun is light. This part is dark. Meaning, the part of your life which is facing the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam will be light. Will be loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jo hissa zindagi ka jiska rukh Huzur alaihi salam ki seerat aur aap alaihi salam ke akhlaq aur nuraniyat ki taraf hoga, jo bhi hissa aapki zindagi ka wo roshan ho jayega. That part will become illuminated. Allah will love that part. If you eat like Rasulullah sallallahu Allah will like your way of eating. He love you. If you sleep like the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah will love the way you sleep. You are asleep, but Allah will love you because you are sleeping at the way shown by the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. If you behave in such a manner following the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah will love that behavior. Your married life, if you do business the way Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam taught, Allah will love that way and that will be illuminated. So he is Sirajan Munira. So as you can see here, so all those people who are not facing the Prophet alayhi salam, they are facing shaitan or they are facing darkness. Their models are someone else. Actors and worldly people and politicians and this and that, and every willy-nilly is their model. They will be in darkness because they are in darkness. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he loves the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and anyone who faces Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam, he loves him as well. Whose life is illuminated, he will have.
So Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is as though the center, is as though the center of actually whole of the spiritual universe. So that is why the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, if Musa alayhi salam was in my lifetime, he will have no option other than to follow me. And who is me and you and then? I am following Zaid, Bakr, Tom, Harry, whoever I am following. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is saying that even if a messenger of Allah was Laukana, if Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam was living in my lifetime, or Sayyidina Adam, Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, Sayyidina Ismail alayhi salam, Sayyidina Dawood alayhi salam, Sayyidina Sulaiman alayhi salam, they will leave all their ways, all their sunnahs, and they will follow the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. But what a shame on me. I am following kuffar. I am following the sinners. I am following the transgressors. I am following the shaitanic people. I am following the gangsters. What a shame that the prophets would leave their path and follow Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and me and you, if we are not, it is just very regretful, very regretful. So son of the spiritual world, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, this is you. Turn your side, your life to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and it will be illuminated. Look what, who was Sayyidina Umar bin Khattab? He's standing in front of an idol. Before, he was standing in front of a but. Ek waqt Hazrat Umar bin Khattab but ke samne khade the. But when he stood in front of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he became Farooq. لیکن جب حضور علیہ السلام کے سامنے آئے تو وہ فاروق بن گئے, وزیر بن گئے حضور علیہ السلام کے. اس امت کے سب سے بہتر سیدنا ابوبکر صدیق کے بعد انسان بن گئے, صحابی بن گئے. دیکھیں others as well, many many other people, when they were away from رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم they were something else. حضرت خالد بن ولید at one time is enemy of Allah. Allah don't love him. But when his life faced the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, the same Khalid ibn Walid became Saifullah. Jab Hazur alayhi salam ke samne rukh nahi tha, to Khalid bin Walid se Allah pak mohabbat nahi karta tha, wo to dushman the Allah uske rasool ke. Lekin jab unhone rukh Hazur alayhi salam ki taraf moda, to wo Allah ki talwar ban gaya. And many, many others. So where is me and you roaming in the universe? There's no other light. There's no other door which is open to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, okay. So now, yes, the brother is saying that sit separately. Children, sit separately so that actually you don't get distracted. So look now at the next screen. What does it say? Have you ever wondered what is a good deed? Kabhi aapne gaur kiya hai, nek amal kya hai? Good deed is nothing but the reflection of the divine and Muhammadan attributes. Jo Allah ki sifat se, Hazur alayhi salam ki sifat se mel kha gaya, wo nek amal ban gaya. Because speaking truth is quality of Allah, quality of messenger of Allah, so speaking truth is good. Allah is free from lying. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is pure from lying. So that is why it is sin. Jo sifat Allah mein nahi, Hazur alaihi salatu wasallam mein nahi, wo gunah ban gayi. Aur jo un mein hai, wo neki ban gayi. Good deed is nothing but the reflection of the prophetic attributes. So Rahman, look here, is why Rahma, being compassionate, is good. Why? Because it is the quality of Allah. why being cruel is sinful, is wrong. Why is zulm? Why is zulm sin? Because it's not the quality of Allah. It's opposite to the quality of Allah. Inna Allah la yadlimu mithqala dharra. So anything which Allah is opposite to the sifat of Allah is sin. It's opposite to the sifat of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a sin. And anything which is reflecting their quality is a good deed. Good and evil. So bad deeds and sins are the opposite trait to the divine attributes. So now, how can me and you become beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? I mentioned to you that why will Allah love you? Because you will have those good attributes. If you have the opposite, He won't love you. So let's say, for example, look at this, your human body. You have 7 organs. Here we are. Tongue, ears, eyes, hands, feet, private parts, stomach, all these 7 organs. So as you can see that if all of them will have those habits, those qualities which are opposite to the qualities of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, opposite to the quality of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will hate you, He won't love you. So if you want to become beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, beloved of the Prophet of Islam, beloved of the creation of Allah, then purify your tongue from all what is opposite to the qualities of Allah. Agar Allah Jalla Jalaluhu aur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam ke mahboob aap banna chahte hain, تو اپنی زبان، کان، آنکھ، ہاتھ، پاؤں کو ان تمام صفات سے خالی کر لیں جو ان کو پسند نہیں ہیں، اور وہ صفتیں لیں جو ان کو پسند ہیں، تو آپ اللہ اس کے رسول کے محبوب ہو جائیں گے. Look, because when a person commits a sin, جب گناہ کرتا ہے بندہ تو کالا سیاہ نکتہ آ جاتا ہے. اللہ اس کو پسند، اللہ does not like darkness. Allah does not like sin. So when a person sins, darkness will penetrate in the heart. Ye dekhe, ye dil mein wo aa jati.
La hawla wa la quwwata illa
billah. And when the heart continuously is absorbing darkness from all sides, when a person is sinning from the tongue, ears, eyes, hands, feet, jab hum aankhein cheeze galat istemal kar rahe hain, to sara dil siyah ho jata hai. All of the heart actually darkens. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said so. Inna al-abda iza akhta'a khati'a nukitat fi qalbihi nuqtatun sawda. When a servant commits a sin, a black spot appears in his heart, meaning his inner self, his mind, all have negative energy in it. So how can you get rid of all these bad and evil traits? As it's not clear if the brothers can make the wires more sound so that the image becomes clear. But anyway, a person can get rid of, let's say, taking an example of the evil qualities. Okay. That's fine, it will come. Yes. Oh. That's fine, please leave it now as it is. So, let's say, for example, these are 20 evil qualities of the tongue. Through this purification, muhasaba, through accountability, you can purify day by day, every day, holding yourself accountable that alhamdulillah, you have not done anything against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's command, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam sunnah, and you can continue ticking until you complete 30 days. This way, your tongue will become purified, so there will be a blockage here. Now, no evil, no darkness is coming through the heart here.
Similarly, when you block the eyes, same thing will happen. So much so that the seven organs, and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "Man yadmanu li ma bayna lihyayi wa ma bayna rijlayi az admanu lahul jannah." Whoever will guarantee me, he won't misuse the tongue and private parts, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "I guarantee Jannah to him." Aap alayhi salam ne farmaya, jo banda جو چیز دو جبڑوں کے درمیان دو ٹانگوں کے درمیان ہے مجھے ضمانت دے دے کہ میں غلط نہیں استعمال کروں گا میں محمد الرسول اللہ اس کو جنت کی ضمانت دے دیتا ہوں. اب ہم کہیں اسلام بڑا مشکل ہے اسلام بڑا مشکل ہے بھائی عقیدہ درست کریں اہل سنت والجماعت کا فرائض پورے کریں اور زبان اور شرمگاہ کو محفوظ رکھیں آپ جنتی ہیں مشکل کیا ہے اس میں اتنے بڑے جو بندہ کام کر رہا ہے اس دنیا میں A person is making, Prophet ﷺ said, "Ad-deenu yusr." Deen to a san cheez hai. Ye to aapko bachata hai. What is difficult in there? You are a Muslim. You have the aqidah of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Offer the fara'id and guard your tongue and the private parts, two only. And Rasulullah ﷺ is saying, you are the person of Jannah. Koi lambi chodi baatein to hai hi nahi isme. Chalo, if you want to have vilaya, very high degrees of spirituality, then maybe you have to do some more thing. Agar aapko wali banna hai, aapko bada bahut buzurg banna hai, phir to chalo koi zyada zikr azkar karna padega. Lekin agar jannat mein jana hai, to sirf zuban sharmgah ki hifazat kar le, farayz pure kare, alhamdulillah, you are on your road to Jannah. Anyway, to aap dekh lein, If your eyes, tongues, ears, everything is purified, agar ye paak ho gayi, Prophet Ali Salatu Islam sifat is reflecting in your eyes and tongues and hands and feet and stomach, then alhamdulillah you have light, you have those good qualities. Similar is the case, purification of the mind. If you use your mind how Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used his mind, you will become beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you use your mind how Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not use his mind, opposite to it, you will actually not become beloved of Allah, but Allah will not love you, he will hate you, he will not like you, because you are going up the opposite way. Because if your mind is darkened with bad thoughts and evil planning, always how I can defraud this person, how I can commit zina tomorrow, how I can take drugs tomorrow, how I can possess the mal, the wealth, the property of others. If your mind is working like this, then it is against the Prophet ﷺ. It is a shaitanic mind. But if it's good, then alhamdulillah, light will come. The light of Rasulullah's teachings, and then your mind will become good. Similarly, the heart can have, you see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is subur. Allah is the most patient. If you have patience in your heart, Allah will love you that this my servant is also subur. But if you don't have patience, you have hatred, you have all of these grudges and all these things of Muslims and others, then obviously your heart actually will not be loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It won't become qalbi salim. So here you are, the heart being enlightened. So now your heart, we can see, and the soul, the nafs, which has bad traits like hasad, jealousy, hiqad, hatred, animosity, love of dunya, anger, and this and that, and ostentation, and riya, and sum'a, and all these things, they are like cancer. But you can replace them with the good ones, like shukr, sabr, gratitude, being patient, love, tawakkul, reliance upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sincerity. So then, your whole body, mind, heart will be enlightened. Phir aapka tamam jism, dil, damag, سارا روشن ہو جائے گا کیونکہ وہ حضور علیہ السلام سے فیض اخذ کر رہا ہے
dekhe roshan aap bhi noor nurani ban jayenge. You will also become light because you will possess light, the light of guidance of Rasulullah. So purification of seven organs, the mind and the heart. So let's see this. Now I'm finishing in last 2-3 minutes. Look at this diagram very carefully, if it becomes clear. You see, on the top, as you can see, the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you can see, hopefully, the qualities, the sifat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is baqi, Allah is tawwab, aziz. Allah ki sifat aapko nazar aa rahi hai, wo haleem hai, wo bardasht karne wala hai, wo maaf karne wala hai. Ye saari sifatein Allah paak ki hai. Ye dekhen, below here, it is Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. His qualities are reflection of the qualities of Allah's qualities. Aap alaihi salam ke jo naam hai, wo bhi sifatein Allah ki sifaton ka aks hai. They are created by Allah. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is shukur, he is nasir, he is rauf, he is rahi, he is halim, he is kareem as well, he is noor, he is hashir. So his qualities are there as well. How me and you can become beloved of Allah and his messenger? Here it is. If a wali, a pious person, a friend of Allah also copies the qualities of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. So he becomes like a small sample of prophetic character. And these are the people, because the topic was how you can become beloved of the creation. This is creation. When you will deal with creation, these creation with these qualities of hilm, of karm, of forgiveness, they will love you as well. Why? One person came to Rasulullah. He sallallahu alayhi wasallam was sitting, and one person came, and Abi al-Abbas radiallahu ta'ala an, ja'a rajulun ila nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam. One person came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, said, ya Rasulullah, ya Rasulullah. He said, ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, dullani ala amalin idha amiltahu ahabbani Allah wa ahabbani an-nas. Ya Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, ya Rasulullah, tell me what can I do so that Allah will love me and people will love me. Waqt khatam to nahi ho gaya. What time is Isha? Is finished? 9:15 is Jama'ah. Now you have to pray sunnah as well. So shall we finish? Okay, chale 2-3 minute mein khatam kar dete. So a person came to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, ya Rasulullah, dullani, tell me a deed which I can do so that Allah will love me and people will love me. Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, izhad fi dunya yuhibbukallah. If you want to love Allah, then detach your heart from the love of dunya. Get love of dunya out of your heart. All these qualities, or at least some of them, which actually are the qualities of dunya and shaitan, save yourself from those. Oh, the love of dunya, detach your heart. Dunya ki mahabbat se dil khali kar lo, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and Allah will love you. Dunya ko Allah pasand nahi karta. If you love dunya, Allah won't like you. Then if you want people to love you, aap kehte log bhi mere sath mohabbat kare. Wazhad izhad fi dunya yuhibbuka Allah, wazhad fi ma inda nas yuhibbuka nas. If you want people to love you, don't compete with people in matters of dunya, they will love you. Don't try to outdo a person. I have a better car than you, I have better clothing with you, I have better fame from you, I have more money than you. Stop competing in worldly matters with people. People will love you. But why we try to do the opposite? We say, okay, he has a BMW, I'll have a Ferrari. Will that bring love? People will love me because of that? No. They will become more jealous. When I don't, actually, then it will end. So we finish here, and inshallah, after the salah, there will be a question-answer session as well, and plus more explanation, because the time was quite limited. I went too very quickly. But inshallah, there will be a zikr majlis, question-answer, and also a little bit of explanation of how you can adopt this methodology. Jazakum Allah ahsana jaza, subhanaka Allahumma bihamdika, nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد ما شاء الله you have heard some of the teachings of as how to become a beloved a person who is loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala his messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم and the creation now is your time to ask how one can become. And regarding that, inshallah, you're welcome to ask any question directly or in written form. But remember the topic, if you want to ask a masla of wudu, ghusl, alhamdulillah, you have qualified imams, mashallah, well, actually, who have studied, who have been authorized in fiqh, hadith, and tajweed and other matter, you can ask them. So our topic today is in relation to tazkiyah, purification, and how we can change our lives. So in relation to that, you are most welcome to ask anything.
استغفر الله العظيم
وعلى اله وصحبه ورحمة الله جي جي نہیں فرمایا صلى الله عليه وسلم صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم
یہ اس کی چند ایک تو قرآن میں ذکر ہے وہ امین ہیں وہ صادق ہیں وہ رحیم ہیں وغیرہ جو ہیں یہ چند ایک ہیں لیکن یہ آپ نے 101 جو آپ کہتے ہیں لیا تو یہ کیا نبی کریم صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے ان سے جو تھا اپنی صفات بیان کی ہیں یا کہ یہ اس کے بعد صحابہ نے یہ لکھی ہے اور دوسرا یہ ہے
صحیح ماشاءاللہ 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 اللہ پاک جزائے خیر عطا فرمائے ہاں آپ نے جیسے سن لیا جو بھائی نے سوال کیا ہے کہ اللہ پاک کے نام تو قرآن مجید میں پائے جاتے ہیں لیکن حضور علیہ الصلوۃ والسلام کے جو نام ہیں وہ کہاں پائے جاتے ہیں تو میرے بھائی یہ پہلے یہ آپ سمجھ لیں کہ جو
قرآن مجید میں بھی اللہ جل مجدہو کے کچھ نام, یہ جو آپ 99 نام سنتے ہیں بھائی 99 نام جو پڑے گا اس کو یہ ہوگا یہ اجر مل, یہ حدیث شریف میں آپ علیہ السلام نے بیان فرمائے ہیں. تو قرآن مجید میں اس کے علاوہ بھی کچھ ہیں, کچھ نہیں بھی ہیں. تو قرآن اور اللہ پاک کے جو نام ہوتے ہیں, نام کہاں سے پیدا ہوتے ہیں؟ نام پیدا ہوتے ہیں صفتوں سے, وہ جو بندہ یہ صفت ہوتی ہے. تو اللہ پاک کے جو اصل نام ہیں وہ تو لا محدود, یعنی ان کی کوئی حد نہیں, کہ صفات الہیہ کی کوئی حد نہیں. اللہ جل مجدہ نے فرمایا کہ اگر درخت کلمے بن جائیں اور سمندر سیاہی بن جائیں تو پھر بھی اللہ کی صفات تو ایک طرف رہے گی, اللہ کی ایک صفت بھی وہ نہیں لکھ سکتے, اتنے یعنی اس میں وسعت ہے. اسی طرح جس طرح اللہ پاک کے تمام نام قرآن مجید میں نہیں, اسی طرح حضور علیہ السلام کے بھی تمام اسماء مبارک قرآن مجید میں نہیں. کچھ حدیث شریف میں ہیں, کچھ جو ہے صحابہ اکرام نے دیے, کچھ جو ہے جو مطلب علماء جو راسخین ہیں انہوں نے دیے. تو بہرحال قرآن مجید میں جس طرح میں نے آپ کو ابھی عرض کی کہ مثلا دو نام ہیں اللہ پاک کے, رؤوف اور رحیم, تو یہی نام اللہ پاک نے کئی جگہ قرآن مجید میں جو ہے حضور علیہ الصلوۃ والسلام کے خاص طور پر ایک جگہ بیان فرمائے ہیں, رؤوف الرحیم. اسی طرح سراج المنیر آپ نے سنا ہے آج کل, یا ایوہ النبی انا ارسلناک شاہد, شاہد بھی آپ علیہ السلام کا نام ہے, مبشر بھی آپ علیہ السلام کا نام ہے, نذیر بھی آپ کا اس میں مبارک ہے. جی نہیں بھائی, یہ بات دیکھیں حضور علیہ السلام کے ناموں کی ہو رہی ہے, یہ اللہ پاک حضور علیہ السلام کو فرما رہا ہے یا ایوہ النبی, کہ اے نبی آپ کو ہم نے بھیجا. اور جو پہلے نبی تھے ان کو بھی اللہ پاک نے بہت سارے ناموں سے نوازا, بہت سارے صفتیں. مثلا میں آپ کو اگر کہوں آپ کے بھی 99 نام ہیں, آپ تو حضور علیہ السلام کے پوچھ رہے ہیں, میں آپ کے بھی 99 نام موجود ہیں. بند انسان کو اللہ پاک نے جو صفات دی ہیں, آپ بھی سنتے ہیں, آپ بھی سمیع ہیں, آپ بھی بصیر ہیں, آپ بھی حی ہیں, زندہ ہیں, آپ بھی علم والے ہیں, آپ کے پاس علم ہے, اس کو کہتے ہیں علیم, بولنے والے کو کہتے ہیں کلیم, دیکھنے والے کو کہتے ہیں بصیر. اللہ پاک نے ہر انسان کا نام یہ بیان کیا ہے. تو یہ دیکھیں یہ کوئی نئی بات نہیں, وہابیوں کا اور سلفیوں کا شروع سے یہ نظریہ کہ حضور علیہ الصلوۃ والسلام کی شان ہو تو ان کو ایک قسم کا جو ہے وہ خطرہ ہو جاتا ہے کہ بھئی یہ پتہ نہیں شرک ہو گیا. شرک تب ہوتا ہے کہ جب اللہ پاک کی صفات جو جیسے اللہ نے پیدا نہیں ہوئی اسی طرح حضور علیہ السلام کی بھی مانے بندہ, تو پھر وہ شرک ہوتا ہے. وہ تو اللہ پاک نے خود نبی علیہ السلام کو پیدا کیا اور آپ کی صفات کو پیدا کیا. میں تو علم ہی بہت تھوڑا ہے, بہرحال میں تھوڑا سا آپ کو بتا دوں کہ امام جلال الدین سیوطی اور اس طرح کے بزرگوں نے ایسی کتابیں ہیں کہ جن میں 500 کم از کم حضور علیہ السلام کے نام لوگوں نے برکت کے لیے لکھے ہیں, کئی جگہ ہزار بھی لکھے ہیں. تو اس میں کوئی حرج نہیں, اگر جو سعودی عرب والوں نے کیا ہے تو وہ ان کی مرضی, وہ اپنا کر رہے ہیں. پوری امت جو ہے جو یعنی میجارٹی جو ہے وہ اپنا ایک عقیدے پر ہے, ان کا ایک ہے, یہ طے شدہ امر ہے کہ ان کا اختلاف ہے اس معاملے میں. تو اس لیے اگر ان کو نبی علیہ السلام کے نام پسند نہیں تو وہ ان کی مرضی, لیکن ہم تو نہیں کہیں گے. ہم تو کہتے ہیں کہ جو قرآن مجید میں بھی حضور علیہ السلام کے بیسیوں نام ہیں, احادیث شریف میں آپ نے فرمایا میں حاشر ہوں, میں ماہی ہوں, میں عقب ہوں, میں خاتم النبیین, یہ اسے قرآن مجید میں آتا ہے. تو یاد رکھیں کہ شرک اس کو کہتے ہیں جب اللہ کی صفت اور اللہ کی ذات کے برابر کسی کو سمجھا جائے. تو حضور علیہ السلام کی جتنی بھی صفات ہیں وہ پیدا ہوئی ہیں وہ اللہ کی صفات کا مقابلہ نہیں بلکہ اللہ کی صفات کا عکس ہے, وہاں سے وہ فیض لیا گیا ہے. تو یہ چیز ہے. تو الحمدللہ یہی ہمارے اہل سنت والجماعت کا شروع سے عقیدہ آ رہا ہے اور اب بھی ہے, لیکن کچھ لوگ جو ہے وہ اختلاف رکھے. لیکن میں نے آپ کو قرآن مجید کا بتا دیا کہ قرآن مجید میں نہ اللہ کے سارے نام ہیں نہ نبی علیہ السلام کے سارے نام ہیں, کچھ ہیں اللہ کے, کچھ نبی علیہ السلام کے, پھر کچھ حدیث شریف میں حضور علیہ السلام نے 99 نام اللہ کے بیان کیے. لیکن ہیں لاکھوں. تو اسی طرح حضور علیہ السلام کی بھی جو صفتیں ہیں وہ بہت, یعنی قرآن مجید میں, احادیث شریف میں. میں نے آپ کو کیا, آپ ایک انسان کسی کا نام لے لیں, میں 99 نام تو اس کے بتا سکتا ہوں, آپ کے بتا سکتا ہوں. آپ حی ہیں یعنی زندہ ہیں. اللہ پاک نے فرمایا سمیع بصیر, انا جعلناہ سمیع بصیرا, کہ انسان کو میں نے سمیع بھی بنایا, سننے والا بھی, بصیر بھی, دیکھنے والا بھی, اور اس کو علم بھی دیا, وہ یہ علیم بھی ہے. وہ سر انسان حلیم بھی ہوتے ہیں, برداشت کرنے والے ہوتے ہیں, صبر کرنے والے جو انسان ہیں ان کو ہم صابر کہیں گے, جو مدد کرنے والے ہیں ان کو ہم ناصر کہتے ہیں, بھائی جو مدد کرنے والے ہیں. اسی طرح جو ہے رحمت کرنے والے, ان کے نام بھی جو ہے رحمت یا رحیم, یہ لوگوں کے نام بھی ہوتے ہیں. اب اصل میں ایک ہی مثال دے کے میں بات ختم کر دیتا ہوں, اصل میں بات ہی وہاں ختم ہو جاتی ہے. آیت الکرسی میں ایک نام آتا ہے اللہ پاک کا آخر میں, وَهُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ. دو نام ہیں اصل میں, تو پہلا نام کون سا ہے؟ علی. یہی نام حضرت علی کا ہے, تو آپ دیکھ لیں کہ وہی نام بہو بہو, کوئی فرق نہیں ہے. اللہ بھی علی ہے, وہ اپنی ذات صفات کے ساتھ جاتی, اور حضرت علی کا نام بھی علی ہے. نبی علیہ السلام نے کہیں نہیں فرمایا علی علی کا معنی تو اونچا ہوتا ہے, اے علی یہ تو شرک ہے, اونچا تو اللہ ہے, آپ تو کیوں کہہ رہے ہیں اپنے آپ کو میں علی ہوں؟ تو اس لیے ایسی بات نہیں, یہ ایک عقیدہ ہے ان کی ناسمجھی ہے, جو سمجھ نہیں آ رہی ان کو. اور جب علماء کے ساتھ بیٹھیں گے, ابھی چچنیا میں آپ کو بتا دوں, چچنیا میں, ان چچنیا گروزنی, جسٹ لاسٹ ویک ہول آف دی علماء آف دا ورلڈ from Syria to Iraq, Yemen, everywhere, east, west, they got together, the big ulama, and they discussed that this issue which is going in actually thing, and they decided that unfortunately that these people who are actually of extreme Wahhabi and Salafi orientated people, that they are not following the mainstream majority from 12th, 13th century. They have decided. Egypt is center of Ahl Sunnah from very beginning, like Iran is center of Shia people. Egypt, Jamiatul Azhar was the foremost actually, and is the center of Ahl Sunnah wal Jamaah. And recently, just in a few months ago, they banned the books of Ibn Taymiyyah and actually some other scholars, Muhammad, that they thought that these books, they take people through extremist ideology like Daesh, like actually Al-Qaeda, and like actually, who are these people? They are not followers of Imam Abu Hanifa or Imam Shafi'i, Imam Ahmad Hanbal. So try to understand. But this is an ideology. یہ کہ پورا ایک ان کا مکتبہ فکر ہے, ان کا نقطہ نظر ہے. ہم صرف یہ کہہ سکتے ہیں کہ ہم اس سے اختلاف رکھتے ہیں, کیونکہ ہمارے بزرگوں کا شروع سے جو سنی بزرگ آ رہے ہیں ان کا یہی عقیدہ آ رہا ہے جو میں نے بیان کیا. اللہ پاک جزائے خیر عطا فرمایا. جی ہاں, ان کو نام انہوں نے خود دیا ہوا ہے کہ ہم سلفی ہیں, انہوں نے خود نام دیا ہوا ہے اپنے آپ کو, ہمیں دینے کی ضرورت ہی نہیں. Sister has asked a question that when one of our children passes away, that how can we soothe our hearts? So remember that passing away, which we have mentioned before as well, doesn't mean that your baby, your child is finished now. It's end of the story. It's not end of his life. Rather, I will just give you an example from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's life. Prophet alayhi sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Madinatul Munawwara, only one son, he had one son was born. His name was Sayyidina Ibrahim radiyallahu ta'ala anhu.
from Sayyida Maria Kibtiya from Egypt. She sent a message to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, like a mother is very much restless. He was very extremely ill. So she sent a message to Rasulullah sallam that your son is very, very severely ill, please come. Rasulullah sallam knew that he is not well and he's going to leave the earth. So he didn't go because she will become upset. And then second message came. Then third message came, and the Prophet ﷺ went there, and her house was little further away from the Masjid al-Nabawi. Our mother of believers lived very close to the Masjid al-Nabawi. She lived about few kilometers away. So Prophet ﷺ went, and Ibrahim radiallahu anhu bin Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was in the hands of Sayyida Maria. And he was so ill, high temperature. And Rasulullah ﷺ could see the malaika, the angel of death, and that they have come actually to take. So Sayyida Maria said to Rasulullah ﷺ that, oh, the Prophet of Allah, we have heard from you that every prophet is given a special dua, that whenever they make that dua is accepted. Whatever they ask, a special dua. And many anbiya used that dua. Musa alayhi salam used against Pharaoh. Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam used it against actually the disbelievers. So he said, every prophet is given a special dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whatever, anything you ask, because some duas are delayed. Some du'as are accepted after some time, some a person gets reward for. But one du'a particularly is given to every prophet. So Sayyida Maria said, Ya Rasulullah, this is your only son alive now. This 2 years, 3 years old, this is your only son alive now. You have no more son. And I've heard that every prophet have a du'a. You must have that du'a as well. Why not use that dua and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give Ibrahim a long life? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was weeping, tears were rolling down his blessed face, and he said, Maria, I cannot do dua for Ibrahim. I cannot do that dua for you or Ibrahim because I have kept that dua for my ummah. I have saved that dua for my ummah, that when difficult time will come or on the day of judgment, I have kept it, I have not used it. It's very precious. Yes, Ibrahim is very precious to me. You are very precious to me. But my ummah is more precious to me than my own children. Imagine, this was the love of Rasulullah for us, me and you, who he has not even seen. So Ibrahim passed away. The angel of death came and took his throne. Now Sayyida Maria was very upset and she was weeping, like our sister have asked a question. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, O Maria, if you want, I'll pray to Allah that he removes the hijab, the veil, and you will see Ibrahim has not been destroyed or annihilated, but Ibrahim is in Jannah playing, and actually he's being fed there, he's being looked after there by angels and hoods. If you want, I can remove that veil, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you will see Ibrahim with your own eyes in Jannah. Sayyida Maria said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I don't want to see with my eyes my son Ibrahim in Jannah, because I believe on your eyes more than my eyes. If I would see myself, I won't have so strong belief that Ibrahim definitely is in Jannah. But because you have said on your word, I believe more than what actually I will see. So I am satisfied. And
I would say same to this sister, that as Rasulullah said to Sayyida Maria, your son is alive, and he has, and especially babies and children who died, they will do intercession. They will wait for you on the doors of Jannah. In the hadith it comes, when children will be resurrected, they will have no hisab, no kitab. Allah will say to them, go and enter Jannah. And the child will stop at the door of Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, go inside. Jannah is for you. The baby, the child, your son, daughter will stop there and say, Ya Allah, I am not going to enter Jannah unless my parents come with me. The parents might be sinful. The parents might be people of hell. A decision has been made for them based upon their amal. But like babies and children, they insist. They insist with parents, no, I want this toy, I want this toy. Similar that those children will do with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya Allah, no, we are not going to Jannah. We want our mother, we want our father. And Allah will accept their intercession and send their people, parents who were destined to hell, now actually toward Jannah. So my sister, you should be soothed in this way, how Rasulullah said, he is living, your son will be waiting for you after you are also going towards that phase of life, and inshallah, if you do sabr, he will take you to Jannah. Sons leave anyway, when they go, when they grow old, when they get married, they're working. How many people are sitting here, their sons are living away from them anyway? Someone is working in Spain, someone is working in America, someone has separated. Some sons are not coming to see parents anyway, they're living nearby. They don't want to see parents. They don't have any respect as such, actually. So everyone have to leave you. No one is going to be faithful or forever with you except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and those people who you love for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So alhamdulillah, they are as though your son is in another country. Think like Pakistan, India, Bangladesh. He is in another country. That country is called Akhira. And inshallah, soon you will meet him as well. Jazakum Allah. Inshallah, yes, you can. I will sit with you after the majlis of zikr in the mosque, inshallah, in the masjid. And how many ever questions you have, I will answer all of them, any brother. So don't worry about time. But we want to take care of people's time. But if you or anyone else has any question, I will sit with you. I won't go until, alhamdulillah, I have not sat with you and answered your question. Do not worry about that. Yes. Okay, mashallah. Yes, please. Yeah, there is a question? Yes. Yes, brother. Malik, sir. Okay, that's fine. I've understood, mashallah. The brother is saying that firstly, the definition of dunya. Remember, the ulama have said, the dunya which is criticized, the definition of dunya is anything which takes you away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It doesn't necessarily, money is not dunya. Money is something good which you can buy akhirah. But in Islam, as Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, or I'll explain in another way, you will understand. One person came to Imam Abul Hassan Shazali. He said, I want to come closer to Allah, but I don't want to leave dunya. I don't want to leave the world. I have a business, I have money, I have children, I have social contacts, friends. Sayyidina Abul Hassan Shazali said, We don't take people out of dunya, out of careers, out of businesses, or out of their whatever lawful activity they are doing. We don't take people out of dunya. We take dunya out from the hearts of people. So this is a two-way to look at, actually, that Islam does not say you shouldn't pursue dunya, you shouldn't actually, but yes, it says that you shouldn't love dunya to the extreme, as so much that when it clashes with akhirah, when it clashes with the command of Allah, then you should prefer Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His messenger, and akhirah. If it does not clash, you can become a king, you can become a billionaire. Don't you know, many of the anbiya were kings, Khulafai Rashideen were the best people, the highest ranking people in this ummah, and they were actually rulers. Sayyidina Abdul Qadir Jilani rahmahullah was a millionaire person. Imam Abu Hanifa was a millionaire person. And many of the awliya, many of the scholars. So it's nothing to do with the money or your career. It is that, as Ahmad, Sheikh Ahmad ibn Ataullah Sikandari rahmahullah, he said that when you do anything of dunya, make intention of akhirah, that dunya will become akhirah as well. So let's say you are pursuing a career. I will just now, through the teaching of Rasulullah ﷺ, also explain to you what dunya is. Sahaba ikram were sitting, Rizwanul Ajmain. One person was rushing to work in the morning, like we go to work. He was rushing to work. Some of the companions said, we wish he was rushing in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fi sabilillah, like this. We wish he did the same effort in the way of Allah. Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, if he is going to work so that he doesn't have to beg from others and fulfill his own needs, he is fi sabilillah, fahuwa fi sabilillah, he is in the path of Allah. If he is going to work or to do business so that he can feed his family, parents, and share his money with the poor, فَهُوَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, he is with, actually, in the way of Allah. But if he is going to earn money and business to show off others, show my car to others, show my house to others, show my bank balance to others, my clothes to others, so that they put other people down, just to actually show and impress people, فَهُوَ فِي سَبِيلِ الشَّيْطَانِ, then he is in the path of shaitan. Then he is in the path of shaitan, if he is pursuing. I think maybe you heard what I said, that what Rasulullah ﷺ said, that مَنْ يَدْمَنُ لِي مَا بَيْنَ لِحْيَيْ وَمَا بَيْنَ رِجْلَيْ أَدْمَنُ لَهُ, whoever guarantees me he won't misuse tongue and private parts, I guarantee Jannah for him. Finish the matter, do whatever you like otherwise. You want to become a millionaire, you want to become a politician or whatever, do. But don't do anything against the Sharia, against the command of Allah, and do whatever. And Rasulullah even said that if the day of judgment, you know that day of judgment has come, the day of judgment have started, if you can plant a tree, do plant a tree, because you get reward for that with the intention.
So that's why, lastly, I finish on the saying of Sayyidina Ali Karamallah Wajhul Kareem, this question about dunya and akhirah, that when you do anything of dunya, do it as though you are living in dunya forever. And when you do worship Allah, do it as it is your last worship. So no one says, I think if you have misunderstood, if you misunderstood like that, or if it's just a question, I'm just clarifying that actually what we are saying is that you purify your organs, tongue, ears, eyes, hands, feet, and mind from harming any people. Otherwise, lawfully, marry one wife, two, three, four, have 10 businesses, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you, whoever one. It is good when person will have ni'mah and blessings, he will actually also, actually obviously share with others. And the dua which you said, Rabbana atina fid dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana, because we are people of dunya, we always interpret these things. It's that Rabbana atina doesn't mean actually dunya there, the best in the dunya. Hasana in Arabic means good deed. And then Sayyidina Ali Karamallah Wajhul Kareem and Imam Hasan Basri and others, they have, many have mentioned the hasana in dunya means obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a good pious wife who can actually lead you to Jannah. But because we are people of dunya, we see dunya everywhere. Someone said, who was hungry, he said, what is 2 + 2? He said, 4 breads. Because thinking of dunya. So when we see this dua, Rabbana atina fid dunya, we think it is about business. No, read the tafsir and you will find that hasana in Arabic means actually the goodness, and the goodness, the ulama, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the sahaba have actually interpreted the tafsir of it through the good deed, amale saliha, pleasure of Allah, pious women. But anyway, as you know that all of these, the best of people of this ummah, Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq, Sayyidina Usman ibn Affan, were the very high-ranking businessmen as well, and very, very actually rich people by heart and actually other things. So it's nothing to do with money. Dunya is, as I mentioned, whatever distracts you from Allah, that is dunya. Even if it is prayer, a person who is praying salah, Allahu Akbar, Subhanak Allahumma bihamdik, but his salah is done for fame and name, to get more praise from people. His salah is dunya as well. And any person who is selling tomatoes, who is selling tomatoes and cucumbers, and he's saying 1 pound per pound, kilo tomato, 1 pound kilo tomatoes, he's saying 1 pound kilo tomato is also worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because he's doing it in a halal way and he is pursuing halal. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this really, this course of purification is for people like yourselves, you're saying, who want to live, who want to do business, who want to marry, who want to live full dunya life, but just extract the poison from it actually. As Imam Ghazali rahmatullah alayhi said, that the dunya is like a snake, and if the love of dunya is like the poison in the snake, if you take that poison out, the snake becomes harmless, then it doesn't harm you. Jazakallah. This is the leaflet, which are free leaflet and free course you can take away with you and do it online or with the brothers here as well. Because how long will we just keep listening to lectures and ulama and think, when will that day come when I start changing and traveling towards Allah? Like Sayyidina Abdul Qadir Jilani rahmahullah says, my son, when you've learned enough knowledge, now close the book of knowledge and open the book of amal now. And then open the book of ikhlas so that you can reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the knowledge is dead without amal and ikhlas. Jazakallah.
Inshallah, if there's any other brother who want to ask a question like this, I will give you opportunity, inshallah, after the majlis, inshallah, dhikr, you can say.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون وقال عز وجل في شان حبيبه إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم السلام يا شفيع المذنبين السلام عليك يا شفيع المذنبين صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه السلام عليك يا رحمة للعالمين صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As-salamu alayk ya khatam an-nabiyyin. As-salamu alayk ya khatam an-nabiyyin. Sallallahu ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sallallahu ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sallallahu ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sallallahu ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Fa'alam annahu la محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. لا إله إلا الله. لا إله إلا الله. Yeah. Allah Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina wa maulana Muhammadin wa ala صلي على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين. اللهم ربنا تقبل صلاتنا ودعانا وأذكارنا وتسبيحنا وجميع عبادتنا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية في الدنيا والآخرة. اللهم إنا نسألك خير هذه الليلة فتحها ونصرها ونورها وبركتها وهداها، ونعوذ بك من شر ما فيها وشر ما بعدها. اللهم إنا أمسينا منك في نعمة وعافية وستر، فأتم علينا نعمتك وعافيتك وسترك في الدنيا والآخرة. يا رب العالمين يا رحم الراحمين، by your mercy and grace accept all our good deeds which we have done in this blessed month and these blessed days. يا رب العالمين. Your Habib صلى الله عليه وسلم said these days are the best loved by you and the good deeds are most beloved to you. يا رحم الراحمين. Enable us to utilize in the best possible way these days. Ya Rahman Rahmin, we seek your acceptance of our good deeds and the good deeds of all the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ya Rahman Rahmin, we beseech you, beg you for forgiveness from all our bad deeds and evils and sins and shortcomings, whatever we have done in our lives publicly, privately, or we have been lazy in any way by offer fara'id and any obligation. Ya Rahman Rahimin, there is no other one who can forgive sins except you. We have no other door to turn to. Ya Rahman Rahimin, forgive us, do our maghfirah, forgive our parents, our relatives, our friends, and all the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, especially those people who are present, if any of their forefathers and mothers and grandmothers, up to Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam, who passed away with Iman. Forgive them and grant them mercy and break their graves, one of the gardens of Jannah. Ya Rahman Rahimin, anyone who is here with the barakah of the majlis of Zikr and this mosque and these blessed days, Ya Rahman Rahim, remove the problems and difficulties and illnesses and affliction of anyone who is suffering. Grant our lawful needs in this dunya and akhirah. We seek the goodness of this world and the goodness of hereafter from you, Ya Rahman Rahimin. Grant us your pleasure and enable us to enter the heavenly kingdom to see and witness your unrivaled beauty, Ya Rahman Rahimin. Grant us the shafa'ah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the love of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, the ma'rifah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Grant us the company of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam in barzakh and in akhirah and on the day of judgment. Ya Rabbal Alameen, Ya Arhamar Rahimin. Ya Rabbal Alameen, Ya Arhamar Rahimin, have mercy upon all the ummah, whoever is any affliction, any problem in Arab and non-Arab lands. Have mercy and help them, enable us to help them, alleviate anyone who is suffering from poverty, oppression of war and zulm of any kind. Ya Arhamar Rahimin, grant barakah in our livelihoods and rizq in our families, in our homes. Grant us the peace in this dunya and in our graves and in akhirah, Ya Arhamar Rahimin. Grant us the knowledge and wisdom from yourself and eloquence so that we can convey the beautiful message of your deen to others, Ya Arhamar Rahimin. Ya Rabbal Alameen, enable us to live by Islam, die with Iman. Bless all the people who participated and who come to this mosque, all the locality, the Muslim, the committee, and everyone through the contribution, all these good deeds and the salah and the classes are going on, and anywhere in the world, wherever the deen, work of deen and da'wah is going on, which is liked by you, Ya Arhamar Rahim. Bless them within them, Ya Arhamar Rahimin.
Even guide the non-Muslim to the light of Iman and the sinners like myself to the light of Taqwa and to the Muttaqeen for Istiqama, Ya Arhamar Rahimeen. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala khayri khalqi wa nuri arshi sayyidina wa nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Amin. تقبل الله منا ومنكم اجمعين لا حول ولا قوه ما شاء الله
کوئی خاص بھائی بس توجہ تاکہ رہے بندے ادھر ادھر توجہ کے لیے ویسے بھی آپ سنیں بات سیکھنا بہت اچھی بات ہے آپ کو یہ علم ہونا چاہیے کہ 5 سال مسجد نبوی میں ذکر نماز اندھیرے میں ہوا ہے ایک صحابی تھے جنہوں نے پہلی مرتبہ مسجد نبوی میں چراغ جلایا نبی صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے پہلی دفعہ جب بتی دیکھی تو فرمایا یہ کس نے بتی جلائی ہے تو پتہ چلا فلاں صحابی نے آپ علیہ السلام نے دعائیں دیں اس کو فرمایا کہ اللہ اس کا جو ہے وہ اماں عائشہ صدیقہ رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ تیل بھیجا کرتی تھی مسجد اقصیٰ کے لیے تو یہ یاد رکھیں یعنی ایسی باتوں پہ اعتراض نہیں کرتے مطلب یہ باتیں جو گناہ کے نبی علیہ السلام نے فرمایا بھائی اس امت میں جو حرام چیزیں ہیں وہ میں نے بیان کر دی ہیں حلال بھی بیان ہے حرام بھی جو ہے وہ بیان کر دیا گیا اب اس امت میں اگر کسی چیز سے منع نہیں نبی علیہ السلام نے فرمایا تو وہ کسی پر یعنی اعتراض نہ کریں جو کر رہا ہے ٹھیک ہے چلو کوئی زیادہ نیکی کر رہا ہے کوئی کم کر رہا ہے وہ ویسے جو یہ آپ لائٹ کا پوچھ رہے تھے یہ توجہ کے لیے اور میں نے آپ کو بتا بھی دیا کہ نبی علیہ السلام نے اکثر نمازیں جو ہیں پہلے سالوں مسجد نبوی میں وہ اندھیرے میں ہی پڑھی ہیں اسپیشلی خاص طور پر عشاء اور فجر اسی لیے آتا ہے کہ حضور علیہ السلام نے فرمایا کہ عشاء اور فجر منافقوں پر بہت بھاری ہے کہ وہ سمجھتے تھے کیونکہ اندھیرا ہوتا تھا مسجد میں تو دن میں آ جاتے عشاء اور فجر میں نہ آتے بھی پتہ ہی نہیں چلتا تو یہ دونوں طرح ہے کوئی لائٹ جلا کے کرے کوئی اپنا بند کر کے کرے بس یہ ہے کہ کوئی ایسا کام مت کریں کوئی ایسا کلمہ مت بولیں جو غلط ہو ایسا کام مت کریں جو غلط ہو باقی اس امت کو اللہ پاک نے وسعت عطا فرمائی ہے اور یعنی برکت دی ہے زیادہ چیزیں حلال کی ہیں بہت ساری کم چیزیں حرام کی ہیں تو انشاءاللہ اس سے جو ہے محبت پیدا ہوتی ہے مسجد پیدا ہوتی ہے اور مختلف مساجد مختلف دنیا میں آپ جائیں تو وہ مختلف طریقے سے کوئی ذکر اونچا کر رہا ہے کوئی کھڑے ہو کے پڑھ رہا ہے کوئی بیٹھ کے پڑھ رہا ہے کوئی لائٹیں بند کر کے پڑھ رہا ہے کوئی مسجد میں ذکر نماز کے بعد کر رہا ہے کوئی نہیں کر رہا کوئی صلاۃ و سلام پڑھ رہا ہے آپ علیہ السلام کی امت ہے اللہ کو یاد کرتی ہے اپنے نبی کو یاد کرتی ہے ان کو کرنے دیں ہماری زیادہ توجہ ان پہ ہونی چاہیے یہ جو لائٹیں چلا کے ڈانس کرتے ہیں ڈسکو میں جو آج اور کل یہ جو لوگ کرتے ہیں نا یہ مسجد والوں کو اور ہمیں فکر کرنی چاہیے بھائی یہ لائٹیں جلا کے کریں یا بند کر کے وہ غلط کام ہے تو یہ جو بیچارے جو 2 ٹوٹرو 4 آ جاتے ہیں مسجد میں ذکر اذکار کرنے آپ کہیں گے تو یہ بھی خالی ہو جائے گی ہم اس طرف توجہ دیں جو باہر کود ناچ رہے ہیں اللہ پاک آپ کو بھی مجھے بھی توفیق عطا فرمائے انشاءاللہ بالکل
there will be opportunity now inshallah let me just move the program on so inshallah for the brothers who are interested as you mentioned brothers and sisters you can put your name forward and you can meet the teacher one-to-one. Now, the program is finished in terms of the question and answers publicly, just to respect the teacher's time, but also the public's time. Jazakallah khair. Thank you very much. And what we'll do now, inshallah, we have our Ustad Majid and Ustad Tahir, who will be explaining the path in more detail. I will take just a couple of minutes to confirm whether there is someone on the sister's side who can also do so. If not, we'll do a joint over the live stream, inshallah ta'ala. And please, if you'd like to see the teacher one-to-one, add your name to the list in the stall outside. I already have some name they'll be putting forward, inshallah ta'ala. And if you are leaving us, then inshallah, there is a little bit of food that we've arranged for yourselves. And remember the all of us in your prayers, especially the masjid committee who has invited the teacher, inshallah, and helped us to benefit from them. And also the website, prophetic-path.com, inshallah ta'ala. So,
Inshallah, as we mentioned in the beginning, that inshallah, now with this opportunity, if some people want to ask anything privately, they can, especially like your brother is saying, he want to ask a question. So you're welcome. Whoever wants to go, they can go. Whoever wants to say anything, ask question, you're welcome. Because I don't want to go in a state that where you have something in the heart and have not asked. That's why I came. So don't worry. I will be sitting until you all are finished, inshallah. Don't worry about that. Jazakallah. Where is the room?